Hello people, welcome back to the digital site and I am 3D Solanki, and in this video we are gonna create card rotating effect. As you can see here, this is Bootstrap Card, and I choose Bootstrap Card because most people use Bootstrap for card. So in this video I will teach you how you can create this card rotating effect using CSS3 properties with Bootstrap Card. So let's get started. On desktop, I have this image which I will use in my card. And first, let's create new folder. Flip card. Okay, now I have this image inside this folder. And as always, I will use my Sublime Text as text editor. So let's bring that folder in it. Let's first create new file. index.html. Let's quickly create structure. Now for rotating Bootstrap card, first we need Bootstrap. So let's go over Bootstrap. Here, getbootstrap.com, and down here you can find Bootstrap CDN and CSS only, because we don't want JS. Let's copy and paste it here. And we also need CSS files, so let's create that. I will name it style.css. Type will be text/css. Okay, now we have Bootstrap, so let's go and grab that card. Component, and in component you can find card here. And for card, I'm gonna take this first example. So let's copy and paste. Now if I save, and if I open, I have this card, but image is broken because we didn't specify the path yet. So let's do that. Card img.jpg. Now save and hit refresh, and here's our card. First of all, let's talk about card's content. In card's content, as you can see here, I don't have any button, so I will remove that button, and I want more text content, and our card is in the center. So let's do that. Let me comment it, and I will add some more text. Okay. Now save and refresh. Now we have card exactly how we want, so let's center it. So this is our card, but for rotating card effect we need parent div which will contain our card. Let me show you. This will be our container which will have this card, this front side of this card, and in this same container we will have this back side of card. So there will be two cards instead of one. And because of this rotating effect, it looks like we have just one card, but actually we have two cards overlapping each other. So let's create that. I will create div with card container as a class. And in here, I will paste our card. So now we have card container, and inside that we have a div. So here we defined our style.css. So first let's create that because we need it. Style.css. And here we defined style with 80 RAM. So first let's do that. Remove it from here. Now this card will be front side of our card. So I will name it. So I will give it class of card front. Okay. And in our CSS file, I will apply that style to our card front. But because this card will be contained in our card container, this style should be on card container. Because we have to align this container, not that single card. MX auto margin top 5. So now if we save and hit refresh, our card is now in center. So let's create that rotating effect. So what we want, when when we hover over our card container, we want our card front to rotate. For that, we have property transform and value will be rotate y to 180 degree. Okay. So now you can see in the result our card is rotating. Okay. But for this, we have to give it transition so it looks nice. So card front. Let's actually give it card just because our second card will also have this class called as card. For card transition 0.9 second, and this will be for all. Okay, now save and refresh, and here we are. We have this nice rotating effect, but still there's something missing. If we look in our finished version, when we rotate our card, feels like this card is coming to user like this. Okay, and in here it doesn't feels like that. And why? It is because of perspective. So first let me give perspective and then I will explain what's that perspective. And remember, always give large numbers to perspective. So I'm gonna use 200 RAM. Now save. And now if I hit refresh, okay, so it is looking like what we want. Let's find out how it will look without that perspective. So if I remove perspective from here, looks something like this, which is lacking something. And if we enable our perspective, it looks like exactly how we want. Okay, so what is perspective? If we go over developer.mozilla.org, perspective is blah 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 blah, but in simple words, perspective is distance between Z plane and the user. As you can see here, distance between Z and the user. In examples, if we do perspective none, this will happen. For perspective 800 pixel, this will happen. For perspective 23 RAM, for 5.5 centimeter. Okay, so this is all about Z plane and user. Okay, so we are here. Next thing is that second card, which will have this background and button. So let's create that. Card back, and in here I just want this button and not text and neither that image. So in second card, which is our back side of card, we have only button. Okay, here you are. So if I go over there, it rotating the front part, not the second part. So let's quickly add rotating effect to second card also. And please note, the upper part will be our front and the down part will be our back part. So if I go over here and on our card container, when we hover, I want card back to rotate. Now save, and if we look at the result, we have something like this. So actually this is working, but this is not what we want. So what's the problem? At initial position, this will be our front side, and on the back side we will have something like this, but that will be hidden. So what will happen when I will hover over that container? Front and back both cards are rotating, but on rotation effect, down part will be visible, and when that will happen, it looks weird because of rotation effect. So what we will do, on card back I will apply transform rotate at its initial position, and on hover I will bring it back to normal. So now if I save and refresh, now on front side this is our card, and on back side, which will be hidden, this is our button. And when I will hover, this will be our front side, which is looking normal, and the upper part will be hidden. And we don't care how it looks. Now next thing is, both of them should be overlapping. For these, we have to use position absolute. So I will give both card position absolute, okay? And for this, I will have to give position relative to our card container. Now if I save and refresh, we will have something like this. But if I hover over this, we have some problem. And why? Let's inspect that. So if we go over card container, it have width of 288 but no height. Why? Because of that positioning. So to fix this, we have to apply height to this card container. So height will be height of our card. So card have height of 412. So 412 pixel. Now save and refresh, and that problem is now gone. Now next thing is, our back card is not at its full width and full height. So let's do that. I will use here height 100%, so both cards will get height and width of 100%. Okay. Now if we save and refresh, okay, so we got our back card overlapping on front card, but we want front card overlapping on back card. And if I hover, both cards are rotating, and this is normal. We are actually looking at the back side of our back card, and our front card is hidden. Now to make visible our front card, we have to use property called as backface-visibility, which will hide the back part of our back card. So let's go over there, and in our card I will use backface, and I will give it hidden as a value. Now if I save and refresh, now our back part of our back card is hidden, so we can see our front card. And this is also same for our front card. So now if I hover, we are actually seeing at our back card, and the back part of our front card is hidden because of that back face visibility. Now this is new CSS property, so let's understand what's that. For that, developer.mozilla.org, and in here the backface visibility CSS property determines whether the backface of an element is visible when turned towards the user. So as you can see here, backface visibility visible, you can see the back part of that cube. And if I use hidden, you cannot see the back part of that cube. So this is what backface visibility does. At first it looks like confusing, but this is very simple. Did you get it? So let's go over our card. Next thing is, we have to give background to this card, and our button should be in center. For this, I will change some classes. In here I will apply BG warning, and instead of BG primary I will use BG success. Okay, so the colors will be changed in our card, and for centering our card I will use trick. And in that card body and targeting a tag, I want position absolute, top will be 50%, left will be 50%, and margin will be -15%, 0, 0, and -25%. Now save and refresh. Okay, so we have our card with that nice rotating effect. Let's change it to 23. Okay, this is perfect. So this is our card rotating effect using CSS3 properties with Bootstrap for cards. If this was helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you in next.